Bees, creatures as small as incredible that give us the most delicious thing in life, honey. In a world surrounded by flowers, bees are essential to nature. But do you know why they are so important to us? Even when we have no contact with them, they keep us alive. Don't believe me? Stay until the end of the video and discover all the truths you haven't been told about bees and their prominent role in nature. Welcome to the Animal Watchers, the wildest channel on YouTube. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button. Let's dive in. Now that it's fashionable to talk about bees, their disappearance, their consequences, and the creation of robot bees for pollination, I will try to explain why bees are so necessary for our survival. As Albert Einstein rightly said, bees are very important for the development of mankind because, without them, 60% of the fruits and vegetables we eat today would disappear because they would not be pollinated. Of the 100 crops that provide 90% of the world's food, bees pollinate more than 70% of them. They also pollinate more than 25,000 species of flowering plants, which tells us that without these insects, agriculture activity would virtually disappear, leaving many families without a source of income. Can you imagine? Bees are one of the most efficient pollination vectors that exist in the animal kingdom, since their work allows plants to carry out the reproductive processes between them in a more optimal way. But to understand this idea of pollination, we must first understand how plant reproduction occurs. There are two types of plant reproduction, sexual and asexual. In the case of asexual reproduction, some plants do not require pollinators. In this case, we speak of a process of self-pollination. As for sexual reproduction, we will say that flowers are the reproductive organs of plants. Flowers have male and female parts. The male part of the flower is formed by the stamens at the top of the flower. The stamens have appendages called anthers. This is where pollen is produced. Pollen is a powder formed by very small, microscopic-sized grains. The female part of the flower is called the pistil. The pistil has a larger area at its base, the ovary, where the ovules are located. The first step in sexual reproduction of plants is pollination, and this consists of the passage of pollen from the anthers to the pistil. Although most flowers have stamens and pistils, it is common for pollen from one flower to travel to the stigma of another flower. That's where our beloved bees come in, right? Biotic pollination is mainly mediated by insects. There are large, showy flowers that usually produce a sweet liquid called nectar. Insects are familiar with these showy flowers and visit them to feed, becoming impregnated with the pollen grains released from the flowers they visit. It is estimated that between 70% and 85% of pollination is done by bees, as most bees carry an electrostatic charge that helps pollen adhere. Therefore, it can be said that the physical constitution of the bee has evolved to become one of the most efficient morphologies to carry out this pollination process. Why am I telling you this? Simply so that you can better understand the crucial role of the bee and the following question. Why is pollination so important? Because through pollination, the pollen grain reaches the stigma of the flower. The pollen grain forms a tube down the style and reaches the ovule. When it combines with the female gamete, seeds are formed. The petals fall, and the stigma and stamens wither. The ovary enlarges, and the fruit is formed, which is the fertilized and mature ovary. Precisely because they are a fundamental part of the reproductive process of plants, bees are extremely important. Without them, a transcendental part of the process is lost. If the work done by bees had to be done mechanically, it would cost about 153 billion euros, according to Greenpeace. Can you imagine how difficult it would be to achieve environmental equilibrium if this process were not natural? Exactly. But how can humanity depend on a simple insect? As I told you, their role in the ecological balance is key, because pollination ensures the birth of plant species on Earth. If the chain fails, so does everything that results from this process. And here we could go on for hours. Bees and plants form a pillar that feeds and enriches the ecosystem. Plants, in turn, feed a variety of insects, birds, and mammals, including the vast majority of species needed for human food. If that pillar fails, everything falls. Now let's talk about the reality that should concern us all, but that no one knows about. The bee population is declining, as we mentioned at the beginning. In the last few years, they have decreased drastically due to several causes that are identified and heard from time to time out there. Climate change, the general increase of drought, and desertification that forces bees to work harder to get food, which shortens their lives considerably. In addition, due to global warming, many plants do not bloom in time for the bees to do their work. Parasites and pathogenic diseases such as varroosis also contribute to the disappearance of bees. Habit fragmentation, the result of human population growth and the resulting alteration of ecosystems, prevents bees from carrying out their pollination process. The use of pesticides on crops also has a serious effect on bees, disorienting them and, in many cases, killing them. What would happen if we continue to ignore the problem and the bees died? If bees were to disappear in the next few years, we would face a number of immediate and alarming consequences in the first year. Crop pollination, essential to our food production, would plummet. Fruit, vegetable, and nut crops would be drastically reduced, leading to shortages and exorbitant market prices. Supermarkets would begin to suffer from a lack of fresh produce, and food insecurity would become a reality in many parts of the world. The second year would be even bleaker, with food shortages leading to social unrest and conflict over scarce resources. The global economy would falter, with agriculture and the food industry suffering huge losses. Biodiversity loss would accelerate, and the food chain would collapse, affecting all living things. Over the years, human extinction would loom on the horizon. Without food, malnutrition and disease would spread. Lack of food for livestock would affect meat and dairy production. Healthcare systems would be overwhelmed, and access to medicines would be limited. Ultimately, without bees, civilization would collapse. Without food and resources, humanity would struggle to survive. Desperate efforts to find alternative solutions would not be enough to prevent extinction. The disappearance of bees would demonstrate the profound interconnectedness of all living things and serve as a warning of the importance of caring for and preserving our natural environment. The loss of these tiny pollinators would be catastrophic for life on Earth, including our own. A little disturbing, don't you think? So, what can be done to protect bees? First, if certain pesticides are found to be responsible for bee declines, they should be banned immediately and less harmful alternatives offered to farmers. In addition, it is essential to raise awareness among politicians and the general public about the importance of protecting bees and halting the loss of biodiversity and degradation of ecosystems. We must remember that we depend on pollinators to solve problems related to food production, and we should not attack bees, as they will not attack us if we do not attack them. It is also important to avoid the use of insecticides as much as possible, as the chemical particles often travel on the wind and end up affecting the bees. Finally, encouraging the creation of vegetable gardens and facades is a perfect option for attracting pollinating vectors to cities and recovering the presence of many insects and birds that would otherwise disappear from large cities. That's all for today, friends. And you know, when you're feeling the buzzing of a bee, don't be frightened by it, don't kill it, and don't chase it. Just let it pass by quietly, because you know that when you destroy a bee, you may be giving more to yourself. So let's take care of the bees. Did you like this video? Then you need to be a part of our community by subscribing and sharing this video. Don't forget, this is the Animal Watchers channel. See you soon.